Assalamualaikum. I hope you all be fine and staying at your home and safe and sound. So today the topic for our tutorial are two micronutrients, iron and iodine. And first of all, we'll discuss about iron. What is iron and what are the physiological functions? What are the resources? What deficiencies our body will suffer if there is deficient iron in our body and our diet? And what effect it would be, it would exert if there is toxicity of iron in our body. So iron, as you all know, is a very richly abundant mineral or micronutrient in all the nature. But it is one of those micronutrients which readily get deficient. Or in the world, the micronutrient whose deficiency is reported worldwidely is that iron. So compared to its importance, as it is, I have already told you that it is a very, very important micronutrient in our diet. The amount of iron which our body needs is really small. Like our body contains 3 to 4 grams of iron, and of about which 60 to 70% is present in our blood in the form of hemoglobin iron which circulates in our blood, and the rest of it is present in the form of storage iron. And each gram of hemoglobin contains 3.34 milligrams of iron. So there are the various functions which I have shown you in this chart, that what are the various physiological functions and what is the physiological importance, why it is important for us to take iron in an adequate amount in our diet, because it helps, as I have already told you, that 60 to 70% is present in the form of hemoglobin. So it helps in the formation of hemoglobin, so it helps in the carrying capacity, it helps in carrying of oxygen in our body. It provides relief from restless leg syndrome. It acts as a carrier of oxygen. It is also important in the development of brain, as every organ of our body needs oxygen for the proper functioning. So it is involved in the brain development. It strengthens the immune system. It helps cure insomnia, anemia, energy metabolism, and it boosts up the cognitive functions. It will help regulate the body temperature. Moreover, the iron is also a part of many enzyme systems in our body, which are involved in the physical growth, in that of the cognitive functions, in the regulation of our body. So iron is important for so many physiological functions. In the root of any of our physiological function of our body, you will find that iron is somehow supporting it. Now, coming to the sources, that what food products should we utilize in order to maintain our body reserves for the iron, or to fulfill our daily requirement, the daily requirement of our body for the iron? What are the sources, or what are the food items which we should utilize? So broadly, these sources or food items or edibles are divided into two. These are called as heme sources or non-heme iron or non-heme iron. As the name suggests, that the heme iron are those food items or the edibles which are derived from the animal sources. Like it can be liver, like it can be meat, like it can be poultry or that of the fish. And the quality which of the heme iron, which is different from the non-heme iron, is that it is readily absorbed in the body. And non-heme iron, it is derived from that of this the plant sources, and it is not very well absorbed, and however it needs vitamin C which helps the absorption. One more thing which you have to keep in mind, that in the your exam or in that of the stations, at times there is a question that what are the things which inhibit that of iron absorption. Okay, एंड अक्सर हमारे पास पेशेंट्स भी आते हैं या हमारे घर में बड़े बुजुर्ग या कोई और ऐसा बंदा जो आयरन सप्लीमेंट ले रहा हो, दे आस्क यू दैट हमने ये सप्लीमेंट किसके साथ लेने, शुड वी टेक इट विद वाटर, शुड वी टेक इट विद मिल्क, शुड वी टेक इट विद टी, व्हाट आर द लिक्विड और द फ्लूइड विच वी कैन टेक विद द आयरन सप्लीमेंट. सो वन थिंग यू मस्ट मेक क्लियर इन योर माइंड, दैट मिल्क और टी और एग, दीज आर द फूड प्रोडक्ट्स विच इनहिबिट द आयरन एब्जॉर्प्शन. सो whenever somebody asks you, or whenever a question comes in your exams, like what are the things, what are the edibles or the food items which you should not take along with that of this iron supplements, or along with that of this food items which contain the rich amount of iron. So these are the milk, this is protein, and these are the eggs. So these are the two sources broadly classified as heme and non-heme iron. Coming to iron absorption and the losses of iron from our body, what happens is that the iron is mostly absorbed in the upper part of the duodenum, in the upper GI tract. उसके बाद it goes to the blood and it gets stored in the spleen and other parts of the body. And what happens in the body is that the iron which is absorbed, it depends upon the need of the body for that iron. For example, in case of pregnancy, in case of a lactating woman in which there is a more need of iron, more iron is, or the iron is readily absorbed into the body as compared to other normal adults. Moreover, as I have already told you that vitamin C rich food like this, say citrus food or vitamin C supplements, they help in the absorption of iron in that of the body. Then absorbed iron is also stored in the form of plasma ferritin, or stored in the liver, in the spleen, in the bone marrow, in the kidney. Now what about the iron losses? A very small amount of iron is lost in urine, in the bile, in the sweat, and moreover when the cells shed from the skin, from the intestinal tract. In females, it's menstrual losses and pregnancy and lactation. क्या प्रेगनेंसी में जो ब्लड लॉस होता है उसमें आपका मंथली साइकिल्स में आपका ब्लड लॉस हो रहा होता है. मोर वन थिंग यू शुड बी कैप्ट इन योर माइंड दैट इंट्रायूट्राइन कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव डिवाइसेस व्हिच मेक्स द पीरियड्स और दैट ऑफ द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल ऑफ अ फीमेल इररेगुलर दे आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर एन इंक्रीज इन एवरेज मंथली ब्लड लॉस एंड रिजल्टिंग इन मोर लॉस ऑफ आयरन फ्रॉम द बॉडी एंड दैट ऑफ एनीमिया. सो इफ द क्वेश्चन कम that what are the causes of that of the iron losses in the body, so you can tell them that these are the losses jo aapke regular hai. You can say regular means that these are the normal physiological losses from the body, ke in the form of in the bile, in the urine, in the sweat small amounts mein hai, ya intestinal gut ki shedding, cell ki shedding se ho raha hai, ya pregnancy mein, ya lactation mein, ya IUDs ki wajah se ho raha hai. But there are other sources which lead to the massive loss of iron and which I will discuss in the next slide. Then these are the other causes of that of the loss of iron from our body, like it can be hemorrhage, any trauma, any injury which lead to that of abnormal loss of subnormal loss of blood from the body. Moreover, as we all know that parasitic infestations like hookworm infestations is very common in Pakistan. So these are the hookworms or the malarial, or in case of like those who consume the junk food, ya jo log jisse se hostel iron, they experience it more like they suffer from peptic ulcer and all this thing. So they are more prone for iron losses from their body. Then in this slide I have discussed it that there are the various causes of iron deficiency. It can be because of blood loss. It can be because of imbalance between the need and between the supply. Like in case of pregnancy, more iron is needed into the body by the body as compared to a lady which is not pregnant. So if this balance is not maintained, then she may suffer from that of iron deficit. Then there may be absorption problem. Ho sakta hai, there might be a problem of the duodenum or upper GI tract. Or these three last, matlab, or we can say that ke diet may hi insufficient hai. Matlab, so you can broadly classify that there is inadequate diet. ठीक है. नंबर टू, अगर एडिक्वेट डाइट ले रही है पर एब्जॉर्ब नहीं हो रहा, इट कैन लीड टू डेफिशिएंसी. अगर एब्जॉर्ब हो रहा है तो बॉडी में प्रॉपर यूटिलाइज नहीं हो रहा, इट कैन लीड टू डेफिशिएंसी. और कि हमारे पास इम्बैलेंस है बिटवीन द रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड बिटवीन दैट ऑफ द सप्लाई. यानी कि अपनी तरफ से तो वो पूरे लेने की कोशिश कर रहा है पर्सन की उसकी आयरन रिक्वायरमेंट पूरी हो जाए, लाइक इन प्रेगनेंसी, बट इट्स नॉट मीटिंग द नीड ऑफ द बॉडी फॉर दैट टाइम. नाउ कमिंग टू दैट ऑफ दिस stages of iron deficiency. If a person suffers from the iron deficiency, so we can categorize him or iron deficiency into three stages. Then first stage is that in which there is decreased storage of iron. Though their stores are present, stores of iron are present in the body, but they are decreased. At that stage, there might not be any detectable abnormality in the body, or there might not be any malfunctioning of the body. The second stage, which is intermediate stage, or we can say that it's that of a latent iron deficiency stage. What's happening in this stage is that the iron stores get exhausted, and this is the stage normally jo hum dekhte hain iron deficiency anemias mein ya iron deficient logo mein. This is the stage where their iron stores are exhausted, and its recognition is via serum ferritin level. Then the third stage is a stage in which there is a massive deficiency of iron. Now what happens is that because of this massive deficiency of iron, the body functions are impaired. A person may suffer from anemia, and the effects of anemia is like shortness of breath, hair, decreased working capacity, and other functional disorders like a decreased immune response, or there is a reduced resistance to that of infections, increased mortality, morbidity, work performance decreases again. So these are the three stages of the iron deficiency. A question can comes to you that if the person is suffering from an exhausted iron stores in the body, what help or what test will help you in the recognition of stage of iron deficiency? So it's the second stage, which is an intermediate stage or the latent iron deficiency stage, and its recognition is by that of the serum ferritin level, which is reduced. As I've already told you and mentioned in that of the previous slide, that iron is really, really essential for many physiological functions of the body, and it can present itself, its deficiency can present itself in the form of maldysfunctions of the body. But the one main thing and which reflects the iron deficiency is that of a nutritional anemia. So nutritional anemia can be defined as a condition in which the hemoglobin content of the blood is lower than the normal as a result of deficiency of one or more essential nutrients, regardless of the cause of the deficiency. So as we all know that along with iron, folate and vitamin B12, which is cobalamin, these are essential for the synthesis of hemoglobin. So deficiency of any of these micronutrients can lead to nutritional anemia. But why iron is important? Because iron is considered as the one of the major cause of the nutritional anemia as compared to folate and vitamin B12. Folate and vitamin B12 say be nutritional anemia out there, but the major cause worldwide is found to be iron deficient anemia. And so anemia, hum kis base se hum keh rahe hain ki anemia kyun hai? WHO, as I have seen, that WHO has set standards for the hemoglobin level. So if the hemoglobin level of an adult person or a child is less than these recommended values, we can say that he or she is anemic. Like an adult male is 13 gram, an adult female is non-pregnant is 12 gram, and pregnant is 11 gram. Children less than 6 years is 11 gram, and children between 6 to 14 years is considered as 12 gram. So any person who has hemoglobin level less than these is considered as anemic, regardless of the cause. Cause हम बाद में देखते हैं कि iron है, folate है, vitamin B12 है, या blood loss की वजह से हो रहा है, ठीक है? लेकिन nutritional anemia बेटा आप सिर्फ तब कहोगे जब ये किसी micronutrient की deficiency की वजह से हो रहा है, ठीक है? And why iron is important in the background of the nutritional anemia? Because iron is considered as that of the most widespread micronutrient deficiency, which is causing that of nutritional anemia. So nutritional anemia is a worldwide problem, but it has its highest prevalence in developing countries as compared to developed countries. Though iron deficiency is the most widespread micronutrient deficiency which affects all the age groups, irrespective of their gender, irrespective of their caste, irrespective of their religion. But for every disease, we identify the high risk groups. What are the high risk groups? So the high risk groups in case of nutritional anemia are the women of the childbearing age, and the young children, the pregnant ladies or lactating ladies, and it is said that, or it has been found that, the estimate that nutritional anemia or iron deficiency anemia, it affects about 2/3 of the pregnant ladies and 1/3 of the non-pregnant ladies. Why more pregnant ladies are affecting the nutritional iron deficiency anemia is that, as I've already mentioned, that in pregnancy the body needs for iron has considerably increased as compared to non-pregnant females. So pregnant ladies are considered as the high risk group for iron deficiency anemia. Moreover, iron deficiency anemia ke aur bhi causes ho sakte, like hamare custom, like in Indians they eat vegetarian food, theek hai? तो उनमें जो है न्यूट्रिशनल एनीमिया के ज़्यादा चांसेस हैं एज़ कम्पेयर टू दोज जहाँ पे मीट और इस तरह की जो है फूड ज़्यादा कंज्यूम की जाती है. एक चीज़ के आपके कस्टम्स हैं या आपकी डाइटरी हैबिट्स हैं, ठीक है? उसके अलावा व्हाट अदर कॉजेस कैन लीड टू, इट कैन लीड टू दैट ऑफ अवेलेबिलिटी. अवेलेबल भी हैं चीज़ें, फिर आ जाती है अफोर्डेबिलिटी. सो दीज आर द फैक्टर्स के अवेलेबल हैं, अफोर्डेबल हैं, असेसेबल हैं, ठीक है? और वुमेंस में क्यों ज़्यादा हो रही है, क्योंकि वुमेंस जो है हमारे पास लाइक इन केस ऑफ रूरल एरियाज़ में या जो डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज़ हैं वहाँ पे दीज आर द निगलेक्टेड ग्रुप. तो उनकी हेल्थ को उस तरह से आप कंसिडर नहीं करते जिस तरह से मेल की हेल्थ को कंसिडर किया जाता है. सो वुमेंस आर और फीमेल्स आर द निगलेक्टेड ग्रुप. मोरओवर हम वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड कि मेंस्ट्रुएशन की वजह से उन्हें आयरन लॉस वैसे ही ज़्यादा हो रहा था, सो दे नीड मोर आयरन. सो देर इज़ अ इम्बैलेंस बिटवीन द बॉडी नीड एंड दैट ऑफ द बॉडी विच इज द आयरन विच द बॉडी इज गेटिंग. सो द वुमेन्स आर द हाई रिस्क. सो दीज आर द फैक्ट्स एंड द फिगर्स विच आर शोन बाय दैट ऑफ द नेशनल न्यूट्रिशनल सर्वे कंडक्टेड इन पाकिस्तान इन 2018. The survey has shown us that about 5.7% of children under 5 years of age they suffer from severe deficiency. And what was the stage? What is the stage which we in which we call that the person is suffering from the severe deficiency? It's the third stage of iron deficiency, in which the person suffers from anemia, in which the person suffers from other maldysfunctioning of the body. And then 48% of the children under 5 years of age they suffer from moderate deficiency of iron. And what is the stage in which there is a moderate deficiency? It is called as the latent iron deficiency stage, which is that of the second stage. And in this stage, the body stores of the iron are exhausted, but it has not manifested itself in the form of any malfunctioning or that of the physiological disturbance of the body. Now, this slide shows you another alarming picture that almost half of the women in Pakistan, they are suffering from anemia, either from severe anemia or from moderate, and half of normal. Like 41.7% are suffering from moderate deficiency anemia. Like they don't have any store of iron in their body. And if they suffer from any major injury, like from injury from hemoglobin loss or the blood loss during the childbirth, they will go toward the stage of severe deficiency. So now you can very well imagine the burden of the disease of the iron deficiencies in Pakistan. So हमने बहुत डिस्कस कर लिया कि आयरन डेफिशिएंसी होती है, आयरन डेफिशिएंसी होती है, ठीक है, बट उससे होता है क्या? अदर एनीमिया, अ पर्सन माइट सफर फ्रॉम हेडेक, ही माइट अपीयर पेल टू अस, ही मे सफर फ्रॉम डिजीनेस, ही सेज दैट आई फील पैल्पिटेशंस. पैल्पिटेशंस क्यों हो रही थी? क्योंकि ऑक्सीजन कैरिंग कैपेसिटी बॉडी की रिड्यूस हो जाती है, एंड व्हेन देयर इज अ लोड ऑन द हार्ट इट लीड्स टू पैल्पिटेशंस, इररेगुलर हार्ट बीट. And these are the other physiological changes or detrimental effects which a person can suffer from or if he or she is suffering from iron deficiency. Then there are the other detrimental effects, as we already discussed, that the pregnancy is considered and the young children are considered as at high risk of suffering from iron deficiency. So iron deficiency can lead to increased risk of maternal and fetal mortality and morbidities. It can lead to abortions, premature births, postpartum hemorrhages and low birth rate. Question beta aksar aap logon se aa jata hai, what are the effects of iron deficiency in a body? Physiological effects, these are the detrimental effects of iron deficiency which can manifest in the body. So how you will diagnose a case of anemia, especially iron deficiency anemia? Anemia to humne sirf se keh diya that HB level are low. I have already discussed in the previous slide, the first slide was the nutritional anemia, that what are the cutoff values for hemoglobin to declare a person to be anemic. So along, लेकिन अब ये hemoglobin low concentration हो सकता है और micronutrient की वजह से हो रही हो, folate की वजह से हो रही हो, vitamin B12 की वजह से हो रही हो. So when we call it that this nutritional anemia because of iron deficiency, so we need to undergo more tests. इसमें है iron concentration in the body which is low. Okay? And it is a more sensitive indicator as compared to hemoglobin level. See? Then there is a serum ferritin level. Serum ferritin is more sensitive as compared to iron level. And serum ferritin is considered as a single most sensitive tool for evaluating the iron status. It reflects the size of iron stores in that of body. Then there is a transferrin saturation. Normally it should be above 16%, normal value is 30%, but we can consider is that the person is suffering from iron deficiency anemia if the transferrin saturation value is less than 16%. So what measures one can take to prevent this iron deficiency? We have broadly classified these interventions and preventive measures as intensive interventions and maintenance interventions. Now, as the name suggests, that the intensive interventions target those in which there is severe anemia, like HB or hemoglobin level is less than 10 grams per deciliter. And what intervention or what intensive measures we take in those cases, we do the interventions with high doses of iron or with that of blood transfusion. Then the second category of interventions for the prevention of this iron deficiency is that of maintenance interventions. These interventions are done in those which have mild to moderate anemia, like in those persons in which the hemoglobin level is 10 to 12 gram per deciliter. Maintenance intervention, as name suggests, is a normally hum log routine mein iron supplements de rahe hote. So it's a maintenance intervention. Okay? So these are classified as in that of intensive, in which you need an intensive management, and then there is a maintenance intervention in those which have mild to moderate anemia. So regarding the maintenance interventions, whom we consider as that of eligible for iron supplements. So eligibility for iron supplements, regular iron supplements, not the high doses, but the regular iron supplements, depend upon the HP level. So those who have an hemoglobin level of 10 to 12 gram per deciliter is considered as eligible. And what will be the requirement or the daily dose which they will be needing to cope up with this iron deficiency? It varies in different age groups, like in mothers, in children, adolescents, the requirement is different. ये बेटा ये जो chart है ये मैंने आपके वो part से लिया है, ठीक है? वहाँ पे सारी ये values दी हुई हैं. And you have to go through through your book, and in order to memorize all these values. Now, what are the other strategies other than that of iron supplementation to cope up with this iron deficiencies in anemia? So these are the dietary habits, as we have already discussed. कि vegetarian में जो लोग मीठी food नहीं लेते हैं, उनमें ज़्यादा होते हैं. So the person should learn to change their dietary habits in order to keep up their iron level. Then बच्चों में, as I have already discussed, कि यहाँ पे hookworm infestation बहुत ज़्यादा, which is the cause of the anemia. So control of the hookworms, and then there is a malaria, then there is a, आप जब पीट के वार्ड में जाओगे आप देखोगे वहाँ पर बहुत से बच्चे आते हैं विद द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ लाइफ इन देयर हेड. और आई हैव सीन किड्स विद द एच बी लेवल ऑफ लाइक 4 and 5 ग्राम पर डेसिलिटर, एंड द सोल कॉज, द ओनली कॉज ऑफ दिस लो एच बी वॉज फाउंड टू बी हेड लाइसिस. सो इट इज दैट मच इम्पॉर्टेंट टू कंट्रोल दिस पैरासाइट. Then there is a nutritional education. It's very important that the person should take a variety of food in their diet. They should take the meat, they should take the green leafy vegetables and multiple food items in their food, and they shouldn't stick themselves to one or two food items. Then there is another concept which is called as iron fortification. Now what is iron fortification? It's the addition of an iron to the food जो आप normal routine में दे रहे होते हैं, like salt है, like rice है, ठीक है, इसमें आप iron add कर देते हो. So you don't have to take iron as a separate supplement. So you can take it in your food. जैसे हमारे घरों में आप लोगों ने देखा वो use iodized salt, ठीक है, it's a fortified salt, iodine has been added. So in the same way iron has been added to that of the salt, and the fortified food, it looks the same, it tastes the same, but improve your health multifold. So the benefit of the fortification is that it is that of you can target a mass as compared to a small group. So it is more economical, and it is as the food items like salt and other stuff is that of easily accessible to the people. So it has a massive advantages when you deal with that of this iron deficiency disorder. So we have discussed a lot about iron deficiency disorders and iron deficiency anemia. We have discussed what is iron, okay, what are the sources of iron, which we have described in the two groups, like heme and non-heme. So what deficiencies a person can suffer if he is suffering from iron deficiency. So but we should not forget that micronutrients, they can get deficient, but on the other hand they can also lead to toxicity if they are taken in that of inadequate amount, or in that of this amount which is above that of the body needs. So iron can present itself in the form of acute iron toxicity, it's because of ingestion of the iron tablet, and then it can present in the form of chronic iron toxicity. So acute iron toxicity, as I have already told you, like in young children who have recently ingested iron tablets, then the treatment is whole bowel irrigation, and then these are the chelating agents. And for the एंड क्रॉनिक आयरन डेफिशिएंसी अकर्स इन दोज जिसमें कंजेनिटली कोई मसला हो लाइक जेनेटिक एबनॉर्मैलिटी ऑफ आयरन एब्जॉर्प्शन. आयरन इज बीइंग एब्जॉर्ब्ड इन द बॉडी इन एक्सेस ऑफ इट्स नीड. एंड देन देयर इज अ रिपीटेड ब्लड ट्रांसफ्यूजन लाइक थैलेसीमिया के केसेस जो होते हैं उनमें रिपीटेड ब्लड ट्रांसफ्यूजन हो रही होती है, उनमें आयरन डेफिशिएंसी हो सकती है. देन क्रॉनिक हीमोलिटिक एनीमिया लाइक थैलेसीमिया में ठीक है RBCs ब्रेकअप हो रहे होते हैं, हीमोग्लोबिन ब्रेकअप हो रही है, तो उनमें आयरन टॉक्सिसिटी हो सकती है. एंड द ट्रीटमेंट इज सेम विद चिलेटिंग एजेंट और इंटरमिटेंट फेलोबॉटमी. सो आई थिंक इट्स द लास्ट स्लाइड रिगार्डिंग द आयरन एंड नेक्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट आयोडीन. So students, the next micronutrient which we will be discussing in today's tutorial is iodine. Iodine is also another essential micronutrient. As you all know, aap logon ne padha bhi hoga, it is required in the synthesis of thyroid hormones T3 and T4 which regulates our body metabolism and involves in so much physiological functions of our body. Moreover, or rather apart from that of synthesis of the thyroid hormone, it is also iodine is also required in minute amount for the normal growth and development and well-being of the human. The adult human body contains about 50 milligram of iodine and the blood level is about 8 to 12 microgram per deciliter. तो व्हाट आर द सोर्सेज विच वी कंसिडर एज दैट ऑफ द आयोडीन रिच सोर्सेज. अक्सर आपके एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन आ जाता है कि आयोडीन डेफिशिएंसी डिसऑर्डर्स हैं ठीक है, व्हाट फूड विल यू सजेस्ट और विल यू एडवाइस टू अ पेशेंट विद आयोडीन डेफिशिएंसी. सो सी फूड इज कंसिडर एज द आइटम्स और द एडिबल्स विच आर रिच इन डैट ऑफ आयोडीन. ड्राइड सीवीड एंड सीवीड कॉड फिश and these are the tuna fish. These are the seafoods are basically considered as the food products or the edibles which are considered rich in that of iodine. So what do you understand by the term goitrogen? As the name suggests, these are the chemical substances which lead to development of goiter. How they will lead to the development of goiter? They interfere with that of iodine utilization by the body and lead to the development of goiter. मैं अक्सर ओसी में या एसईक्यू में ये क्वेश्चन दे देती होती हैं कि व्हाट आर द ग्वाइट्रोजन ठीक है, गिव एग्जांपल ठीक है. आपकी उसमें एक्सेल में बेटा ग्वाइट्रोजन नहीं मेंशन है ठीक है. दीज आर मेंशन इन दे आर मेंशन इन पार्ट ठीक है, दैट व्हाट आर द ग्वाइट्रोजन एंड द ग्वाइट्रोजन एग्जाम्पल इनकी ये है कैबेज कॉलीफ्लावर्स एंड ब्रोकली. दीज आर द लीफी वेजिटेबल्स विच आर कंसिडर्ड एज पार्ट ऑफ द ग्वाइट्रोजन. इनका एक्सेस यूज it can lead or interfere with that of iron utilization and lead to the development of goiter. So as I have already discussed that iodine is really really essential for the well-being of a human body for the normal growth and development apart from the synthesis of thyroid hormone. So regarding iodine deficiency disorder, so what are the iodine deficiency disorders? Iodine deficiency disorders is a wide spectrum of disorders. They can affect from the fetus and they can exert their effect during their childhood period or in the adult life. So these are the broad spectrum of the disorders which can manifest itself and when there is a deficiency of iodine in the body. So what are the reasons or the causes of this IDD or iodine deficiency disorder? As we have discussed in that of iron deficiency, that the causes can be broadly classified as because of inadequate intake or because of inadequate absorption or because of losses. In the similar fashion, we can discuss that we can divide that iodine deficiency disorders can be because of decreased dietary intake of iodine or it can be because of inadequate utilization, as we have discussed that goitrogen which interfere that you are taking adequate amount of iodine in your food, but there are goitrogens which are present and in excess which are interfering with the iodine utilization leading to IDD. So iodine deficiency disorders, as I've already told you, that they refer to all the effect of iodine deficiency of human growth and development, and they can affect any age group from the fetus, from the infant life stage, neonate to child, adolescent and adults. It can present in the form of, like in fetus, it can lead to spontaneous abortion, stillbirth, congenital anomalies. In children, it can lead to that of cretinism, neonatal hypothyroidism. And in children, impaired mental function, delayed physical development. And adults, they can lead to that of impaired mental function and iodine-induced hypothyroidism. And in all age groups, irrespective of the ages and the gender in the cast, IDD can present in the form of goiter or the hypothyroidism. So in Pakistan, it is considered that more than, or the stats have shown that more than one third of the population is at increased risk of suffering from iodine deficiency, especially those in the mountainous areas like Upper Punjab, like Naran, Kagan, Balakot. They are considered as the high risk areas for iodine deficiency disorders. First time in 1908, Northern Punjab and hilly areas of KPK are considered or marked as that of iodine deficiency area. Moreover, in apart from this high risk area, what are the high risk groups? The females and children. Again, the most neglected groups are considered as a high risk group. And why women in that of the pregnancy is considered? Because of increase in the demand. And why the children are considered as a high risk group? Because of the growing age, there is an increase in the demand of the body, and when there is an imbalance between the demand and supply, it lead to that of iron deficiency disorders. So one of the very, very important FAQ or OSCE questions, that what are the tools which we use for the epidemiological assessment of iodine deficiency? So these are the indicators of iodine deficiency. These are prevalence of goiter, prevalence of cretinism, prevalence of neonatal hypothyroidism, urine iodine excretion, and measurement of T3 and T4 level. Urine iodine excretion is normally used for the purpose of surveillance. Neonatal hypothyroidism is a sensitive indicator of environmental iodine deficiency. So if the question comes like in MCQ or in OSCE, that what is the best sensitive indicators for the measurement of, or yeah, for the assessment of environmental iodine deficiency, so it's neonatal hypothyroidism. Okay, and when it comes to that of having thyroid function test taking ho, to usme kaun sa sensitive indicator, it is T4 as compared to that of this T3 level. So these are the different epidemiological assessment tools for the measurement, for the assessment of iodine deficiency. Ma'am aksar beta pooch leti hai, what are the indicators which we use to assess the level of iodine deficiency in a community. Okay, so these are the indicators. So jaise maine beta aapko pehle bataya hai ki hilly areas or mountainous area Upper Punjab ke, okay, Naran, Kagan, Hunza, all these are considered as a high risk area for iodine deficiency disorders. So endemic goiter occurs frequently in this population. ठीक है, मोस्टली अफेक्टिंग द टीन्स, द चिल्ड्रन, द फीमेल, स्पेशली द प्रेगनेंट लेडीज. ठीक है, सो इंटरवेंशन मेजर शुड बी टेकन अगेंस्ट आयोडीन डेफिशिएंसी डिसऑर्डर्स. WHO रिकमेंड दैट एटलीस्ट 150 माइक्रोग्राम ऑफ आयोडीन शुड बी कंज्यूम्ड इन केस ऑफ नॉन प्रेगनेंट लेडीज, एंड इन केस ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी द रिकमेंडेड वैल्यू और द रिक्वायरमेंट इज 250 माइक्रोग्राम पर डे. So in 1977, the interventions or the intervention measures were taken against this iodine deficiency disorders. At that time, iodized salt was supplied and distributed to the residents of Gilgit and Hunza valleys with the help of international organizations. The population of this target area was estimated at that time, according to the census of that time by the government of Punjab, and then the iodized salt was provided to them. एज जैसे मैंने आपको बताया है, आयरन में आयरन फोर्टिफिकेशन है, सो इन द सेम वे आयोडाइज सॉल्ट फोर्टिफाइड सॉल्ट. ठीक है, विच इज फोर्टिफाइड विद आयरन. बट लेटर इन 1994 अ रेगुलर प्रोग्राम वॉज इनिशिएटेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ पंजाब, विच वॉज कॉल्ड आयोडीन डेफिशिएंसी डिसऑर्डर कंट्रोल प्रोग्राम टू इम्प्रूव द हेल्थ ऑफ स्टेटस ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन व्हेन इट कम्स टू आयोडीन डेफिशिएंसी डिसऑर्डर्स. So what are the components of the control program, this iodine deficiency disorder control program, which was launched by the government of Pakistan? There are the four components. First is the provision of iodized salt. Iodized salt is now considered as the most widely used prophylactic public health measure against the endemic goiter. and it has the advantages like it is economical, it is convenient, it is an effective way of that of mass prophylaxis. So it is considered as one of the effective ways to combat this iodine deficiency disorders, and when your aim is to target a mass population rather than a close community. Then number two is that of iodine monitoring. अभी मैंने आपको पिछले बताया था जब हमने epidemiological assessment tools discuss किए थे that what is the most sensitive indicator to assess the environmental deficiency of iron, and that the most sensitive indicator is and the most sensitive indicator is that of the iodine excretion of urinary excretion of iodine. So, it is that of the neonatal hypothyroidism, which is considered as the most sensitive indicator of the environmental iodine. So, along आप provide तो करें iodine salt, but deficiencies cope up भी हो रही हैं कि नहीं हो रही. So, you need iodine monitoring. Then you need the manpower. What do you understand by the manpower? Those who are responsible for the distribution of iodine salt, the healthcare workers, the laboratory workers. You need the training for each and everyone. And then there is the mass communication. Mass communication is considered as a powerful tool for nutritional education. It should be fully used in quality control work. Creation of the public awareness is also a very important or the crucial component regarding this iodine deficiency disorder control program. Though this program was initiated in 1994 by the government of Punjab in collaboration with that of international authorities to combat or to deal with the deaths of iodine deficiency disorders or to deal with the iodine deficiency in the prevalence or the disease burden in Pakistani population, these efforts resulted in decline of the iodine deficiency, but the country is still struggling. Why? Because of many reasons like lack of proper planning or low health budget, political will, monitoring nahi hai, public awareness nahi hai, okay? And moreover, jo hamare yahan sabse zyada ek you can say that a barrier hai for anything, that the great percentage of population is reluctant to use the salt. They consider as they won't allow their families to consume this because they call it a mixed salt, believing it caused to infertility. Myths hai, ek bahut bada barrier hai in the success towards the success of this iodine deficiency disorder control program. This is a report of National Nutritional Survey which was conducted in 2018 that 79.6% of population all over Pakistan is using iodized salt, 84.4% in urban and 76.7% in case of rural. Yet there is 20% of the population which is still not using this iodized salt, considering is that it may cause a havoc to their health, it will damage their health rather than giving benefits to them. So beta, this is all for iodine and iron. We have discussed the sources, we have discussed their physiological importance, we have discussed their deficiencies, what are the reasons of their deficiencies, we have discussed what are the indicators for the assessment of iodine deficiency, for the assessment of iron deficiencies, what preventive measures can be taken and what preventive measures have been taken by the government of Pakistan, and what is food fortification, iodine ke bare mein ho chahe iron ke bare mein ho, theek hai, what are the epidemiological assessment tools for the deficiencies of this micronutrient. Theek hai, if you have any query please write it in the comment box, I am here and to answer your questions, or you can message me as well, and that's all for today. Thank you.